Hi, I'm Sandra Garcia, and welcome back to Eat Healthy Fontana. We're going to start a two-part series on substituting vegetables with different forms of carbs, whether it's bread, pasta, or rice. If you haven't heard of this craze that's going on, well, I'm here to tell you about it. It's really a great thing because what's happening is that instead of using pasta, like we're going to be doing in today's recipe, we are going to be substituting it with spaghetti squash. I know that sounds really crazy, but it's actually really delicious. So we're going to be making some turkey stuffed meatballs with mozzarella cheese on top of spaghetti squash. And this is a spaghetti squash. This is what it looks like. It's this beautiful yellow color. And why they call it a spaghetti squash is because when it's cooked, the flesh inside resembles spaghetti. It grows here all year long. It's a summer and winter squash, but here in California, we can get it whenever. And when you're gonna go to pick your spaghetti squash, there's a couple things you wanna look for. You wanna make sure that it's nice and even. It is an oblong shape, but it shouldn't be, you know, one side shouldn't be bigger than the other. It should feel heavy for its weight. And also, you wanna make sure that there's no cracks in it, that each side of its top and its end are really nice and firm. And especially when you go to the farmer's market, a lot of the times the stem will still be attached, and that's how you know you're getting a really fresh spaghetti squash. And here in Fontana, we have a wonderful farmer's market every Saturday, so make sure that you look out for that. And now how we're gonna prepare this is really, really simple. We're gonna cut it in half, and it is really, really tough, so use a big knife. And you'll see inside that it has a lot of seeds just like any other squash, and because it is so firm, the best way to scrape all these seeds out is just to get a little knife, a paring knife or a bird's beak knife is what I'm using today, because it allows you to have a really good control as you go around. And we're just gonna kind of score it to get all this pulp and the seeds removed. And then just with a spoon, you're gonna scrape it out. Spaghetti squash is not only nutritious, but it's really, really so flavorful. It takes on anything that you flavor it with, whether it's garlic, olive oil, you know, spices, herbs. It's like a sponge, so it's gonna suck up all those flavors. So I'm gonna do the other one. And now you can cut these in the oblong shape, just in half, or you can cut it how I did it today. And the reason why I cut it like this is because I wanna make little bowls out of it. So we're gonna be serving our sauce and our meatballs inside these little bowls. And it's just a really cute way to present it. So I'm just gonna finish scraping all these seeds out. And you wanna make sure that you get it really, really clean inside, because after it's done cooking, we're gonna be shredding the flesh so that it looks like our noodles. And we don't wanna have any little hard bits of seeds or the inside of the pulp. So there are a couple different ways to prepare spaghetti squash. Really, really simply, all you can do at this point, wrap it in some Saran wrap, pop it in the microwave for a couple of minutes, and it's cooked quickly. But I like to roast these because it really gives it a lot of flavor. So to put these on a sheet pan, what I'm gonna do is cut some of the bottom portion off so that it can stand upright. And you just kinda wanna level it off so it stands just like that. Sometimes that stem or the bottom of the stem gets in the way, and you can see that they're much more stable. So what we're gonna be doing is placing these in a 450 degree oven for about 40 minutes. And depending on how big your squash is, it might take a little bit longer. Spaghetti, these are quite small. They're about 8 inches, but they can grow up to about 14 inches. So they can be really, really huge. So sometimes that might take a little bit longer. So I'm just gonna get a sheet pan. And we're gonna be lining it with foil. And make sure that you preheat your oven. And all we're gonna be doing is drizzling some heart healthy. One seed got away from me. Let me get that out. We're just gonna drizzle them with a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. It has to be a heart healthy oil. And just take your fingers and kind of swirl it around in there, or you can use a pastry brush. And we're gonna be putting it all over. And use really good quality olive oil for this, because you really will be able to taste it. And then we're gonna be putting some cracked black pepper and kosher salt. And then what I like to do is use a little bit of Italian seasoning just to add some extra flavor. And then we're gonna be sticking a smashed garlic clove inside of these, so that while it's roasting, the garlic flavor is gonna get all incorporated into the squash, and when we shred it, all that flavor is gonna get in as well. So that's it really for preparing these. We're gonna stick these into an oven so that they can roast, and then we'll get started on the meatballs. Okay, so we're gonna get started on the turkey meatballs, and in here I have 93% lean ground turkey. And you wanna make sure that you're looking for the leanest turkey you can get, because otherwise it wouldn't be as healthy and you could just use regular ground beef if you prefer, but make sure that you get the ground beef as lean as you can get it as well, because we really wanna watch our fat intake and our cholesterol and all that. So we have our turkey in here. I'm gonna be putting some onions in here. Just a little bit. Now, if you are opposed to putting onions in, you could just use some onion powder. And I'm just going to be small dicing it. This is a Spanish onion, but you could really use any type of onion. And I always like to make sure that we're getting plenty of onions and garlic into our recipes. And the reason for that is because onions and garlic, or anything in that family, contain so much cancer-fighting properties, antioxidants, things like sulfur. They have a lot of antibacterial properties as well. So that's really healthy for our bodies. So whenever you're starting the base of a recipe, whether it's a soup or a baked chicken dish or making even sauces, make sure that you incorporate those as much as you can. And fresh is always best. So I'm gonna be putting some onion in there, as well as I'm gonna be adding some fresh garlic, of course my favorite. And we're just gonna chop these up as small as we can get it. And of course you could put all this in the food processor to make it a little bit easier, or to make sure that it's chopped really nice and small. But I'm just gonna use my knife. And when you are roasting your squash, you'll really start to smell all those delicious flavors. It kind of has a sweet smell to it when it's roasting. And because we are roasting it, that squash is just gonna be really intensely flavored and be delicious. If you are not a fan of squash, let me tell you, this will really change your mind. You will be hard pressed to realize that you're not eating real pasta. And I've had tons of friends and family that are not squash fans, but they really love spaghetti squash. So I really hope that you all try it. So to this, we're adding some Italian seasoning. And I always like to add a little bit of heat with some chili flake, as well as we're gonna be adding some fresh herbs. I have some Italian flat-leaf parsley here. And I'm just gonna break some off. And I'm also going to be adding some fresh basil. I really want to get as much flavor into these turkey meatballs as possible. So I'm just going to be chopping these in here. And it's really going to make the meatballs look really pretty as well. So to this, to really make it as gluten-free as possible, for those of you that are gluten intolerant, or you're just simply trying to watch your carb intake, these meatballs and this dish in general are really great for that, because we're not going to be adding any breadcrumbs to these meatballs. Okay, one egg. I have an organic brown egg here, and we're just going to mix that up a little bit, pour it into our meatballs, and then we're going to be adding some freshly grated Parmesan cheese, as well as some salt and cracked black pepper. And I'm just going to get that all mixed up, and then I'll show you how to stuff them with some fresh mozzarella. So we're making sure that everything is well incorporated. And remember, because these do not have any breadcrumbs in them, they're going to be a little bit stickier than normal. So what we're going to try to do is pick them up really kind of lightly, be light-handed with these. Form them into a ball, and then taking our mozzarella, fresh mozzarella, we're just going to be shoving them in the middle just like that, and then lightly form the turkey meat around just like that. Remember, a light hand is key. And I'm just going to set these down with the rest of them and pick up the rest of my turkey. Remember, light again. And these are going to be really beautiful when they cook, because they are so light in color. You'll be able to see all the herbs flecked through them. And we remember, we have basil in here. We have parsley. Basil is also a really good herb to incorporate into your diet, because it has so many flavonoids, which are antioxidants, and they help fight the free radicals from damaging our cells. So that's really important. And they also have a lot of antibacterial properties that help ward off bacteria. So that's really important. Plus, it tastes amazing. So right here on the stove, I have a fry pan heating up. We want to get it super hot. We're only going to be putting just a little bit of extra virgin olive oil in there. And you could bake these as well on a sheet pan at 400. You can bake them without any oil. Just line a sheet pan with some foil, maybe a little bit of high heat cooking spray so they don't stick. So just a little drizzle in here. And we're going to swirl that around. We just don't want them to stick. We'll turn down the heat a little bit. And then we're going to gently place them into the pan. And we're just going to be browning these on all sides, and then we'll finish cooking them in a tomato sauce. Now, with the tomato sauce, you can buy a nice sugar-free organic one at the grocery store, or you can make one in the pan really quick. The meatballs are going to give the sauce a lot of flavor. But what's great about eating Italian-based foods is that it does have a lot of those fresh herbs and garlics and onions and tomato sauce, which, if you haven't heard, tomatoes contain a powerful antioxidant called lycopene, and especially when you eat cooked tomatoes, because tomatoes are fat-soluble, and that means that When you pair them with a fat like extra virgin olive oil, especially a heart-healthy fat like extra virgin olive oil, or say avocados or grapeseed oil, your body easily absorbs all the vital minerals and vitamins and nutrients that you wouldn't get in just eating regular fresh cut tomatoes. So when it comes to eating fresh, I always say fresh is best, but in terms of tomatoes, actually cooked is best. So we're gonna let our meatballs saute in here. We're looking for a brown crustiness to start forming on the meat. Don't touch them, let them cook for a while, and then go ahead and turn them, and then we're gonna be putting our tomato sauce into the pot and let them finish cooking. I'm gonna check if my turkey meatballs are ready to flip. And they are, they're nice and browned on the other side. So I'm just gonna go ahead and flip all of these really quickly. And again, you wanna be careful when you're flipping them because remember, they're stuffed with fresh mozzarella cheese, which by the way, when you're looking for mozzarella cheese, you wanna look for the part skimmed, which is much lower in fat. And either you can get pre-marinated or just ones that are just enclosed in water. And you can see that my pan is not oily at all, and that's what we want. A good nonstick pan will brown it with very, very little oil. So at this time, we can add our marinara sauce or just your plain tomato sauce. And we're going to continue cooking our meatballs in this sauce. And it already looks beautiful and smells great. And if your cheese starts to ooze out a little bit, that's okay. Don't worry about it. It's going to taste just fine. We'll put a lid on it and let it simmer for about 20 minutes until it's all cooked through. But I already have some done. And nice and cooked in our pasta. And so our spaghetti squash is ready, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like when it's done roasting. And here it is. You can see that it has some nice caramelization around the edges, and that's what you're looking for, but it's still held its shape. And our garlic cloves were nice and roasted inside. You can remove those if you wish. And we'll just set those aside. And I'm so excited to show you how this totally shreds and pulls apart just like spaghetti. And you can see that it looks just like spaghetti noodles. It's really cool. But not only is it cool because it looks like spaghetti, but it's so much more superior than pasta is because it has about 457% of your daily recommended vitamin A, as well as 53% of your calcium. In this cup right here, it is only 42 calories and 10 carbs compared to a 3/4 cup of pasta, which is 200 calories and 41 carbs. That's a huge difference. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be adding our turkey meatballs into this, and I'm gonna show you how to plate it beautifully. Let me get my plate here. And it makes a really lovely presentation. And we're gonna be adding some sauce and some meatballs to this, and it makes a nice little bowl that's absolutely beautiful and delicious. And you can drizzle some sauce all over it on the side, let it spill out. And I always shred the spaghetti squash a little bit just to make it easier for my guests, but leave some of it so that you can have them shred it on their own. I'm just going to add a little bit more Parmesan cheese to the top. And then just some fresh basil. And there you go, guys. There is your turkey meatball stuffed with mozzarella in a spaghetti squash bowl. I hope that you enjoy this and you incorporate spaghetti squash into your diet in replace of pasta. Not only is it delicious, but it's really good for you.